Guess what? There's a new type of virus you've probably never heard of. But don't worry, these viruses don't infect humans, or plants, or animals, or fungi, or protists, or bacteria. These viruses infect other viruses. The first virophage, named Sputnik, was discovered in 2008, along with the giant virus it infected, called mammavirus. Giant viruses are pretty straightforward. They're just really large viruses. How big? Mammavirus is twice the size of some bacteria, which is crazy because usually bacteria are much larger than viruses. And giant viruses aren't just large in size, they also have a really large genome, which is just another way to say they have a lot of DNA. So now that we've covered giant viruses, let's go back to what I said at the beginning. These viruses infect other viruses. So what did I mean by that? Well, viruses infect their hosts because they cannot reproduce on their own. They take control of the host's protein-making machinery to create a virus factory, which produces viral proteins, and once the host cell is full of viruses, it explodes and the viruses rush out to infect more cells. Other than not being able to replicate on their own, viruses do not maintain homeostasis or grow, which is why many scientists do not consider them to be alive. But they're not dead either, because they were never alive to begin with. So how can something that's not alive infect something else that's not alive? Short answer, they can't. Instead, virophages are parasites of giant viruses. A parasitic relationship is where one organism benefits and the other is harmed. Virophages need the help of a giant virus to reproduce. However, virophages prevent the giant virus they infect from reproducing properly by stealing its virus factory. Because they benefit while the giant virus is harmed, virophages are considered parasites of giant viruses. In fact, many organisms infected with a giant virus infected with a virophage have shown higher survival rates than those without a virophage. This is because the virophage steals the giant virus's virus factory, preventing it from reproducing. This, in turn, helps the amoeba because the virophage is much smaller than the giant virus. Sputnik is 1/15th the size of mammavirus. Giant viruses have the genes to infect all kingdoms of life, but so far they've been found in protists like amoeba and plankton. They have also been found in humans suffering from pneumonia, though we don't know if the viruses were causing the disease or were just there. Right now, the evidence that giant viruses may infect humans is fairly slim, but it's still an open question. There's so much more that we don't know about virophages. In fact, we only know the function of half of the encoded proteins in most virophages' genomes. Understanding these mysterious viruses may help us answer the question of what counts as life, and some scientists even believe that they may be the key to understanding the origin of eukaryotic cells, which is what you and I are made of.